It's become a place of infamy in Macon. The Barristers Hall apartments across from Mercer Law, forever marked by the evil that happened behind its walls. As time has passed, new classes of Mercer Law students have moved in. To apartment 2, where Lauren Giddings was strangled to death and dismembered by Stephen McDaniel, and to apartment 4, where the killer lived. But how would you feel living somewhere with a tragic history?
We can't really stigmatize a property with a certain claim about somebody that may have lived there or passed away there. Gosh, the history of properties all over middle Georgia would be difficult to know.
You might be surprised what history is in your own neighborhood. Check out this house, big yard, white picket fence, beautiful neighborhood in Jones County. From looking at it, you'd never know that back in 2011, around the same time Lauren Giddings was murdered, a wife shot her husband here, then bonded out of jail and killed herself. If walls could talk, they might tell you more than a real estate agent. By Georgia law, brokers aren't required to disclose whether a property was the site of a homicide or other felony, or a suicide, or a death by accidental or natural causes. It does say, though, if you ask, they're obligated to tell you the truth to the best of their knowledge. But there's no legal penalty if they don't, unless they purposely defraud you. According to the Georgia Landlord-Tenant Handbook, the same rules apply to apartments. Steve Solomon says he tries to tell his clients as much as he knows.
If there is something that we're aware of and it was notorious, then we would tell them, you know, I might want to look up this and see, you know, what happened on this particular property. But there's really no way to know without being told, you know, what's happened in a history of a property.
In some cases, buyers don't mind. Someone recently bought the house on Stinsonville Road where Gail Spencer was murdered in 2012.
That buyer knew about it, and to him it was not a situation that he was very concerned about, but you know, the property did sell, and he's moved into it and been living there, I think, 4 or 5 months now.
So just as for any home buyer, doing your homework is still key. In Macon, Tom George, 13 WMAZ Eyewitness News.